friends, welcome to Suni Art. This is Suni. Hello, 大家好，欢迎来到 Suni Art， 我是 Suni。Today I want to going to share with you how to use the rice paper to glue on this tiffin. 今天呢，想跟大家分享呢，如何用这个我们最新系列的棉纸呢，来拼贴在这个提盒上。你可以用任何你有的棉纸来拼贴啦，只是今天我想分享的呢，是我们这个最新系列的。You can use any design of the rice paper to glue, but to do this tiffin. But today I'm going to share with you with our latest design. Okay, this design, this series is special made for the coming Hari Raya celebration. 这一系列的图纸呢，就是特地设计给我们这个要来临的那个开斋节啦。OK， 所以呢，这个图纸呢，它主要呢，它是你可以随性的你自己铺排，你要如何组合都可以。And this very unique of this paper is that you can have any combinations that you like. It's, all the combinations will be very nice also. Okay, this series of paper, we have total 24 design. 这系列的图纸呢，我们一共有24款。你可以随意的组合。So you can do any combinations you like. So it's a very unique design actually.它是一个蛮独特的一些设计啦，就是看你如何自己设计和铺排。So just depends on how you going to do the combinations and your own creativity. Okay, 就是你的创意。Okay, 这个是粉色系的。Oh, here more pinkish color. So you can match like this also. You see, look very nice also. 你看这样子的组合其实也是蛮特别的。See, okay, or you can match with this also.This tree, okay, 都是蛮，我觉得蛮，对我来说是蛮特别的一个，就是跟别的会有一点不同啦。So to me is more special and unique and different from others. Okay, so now I'm going to teach you how to glue this paper. At first, you have to cut out the paper according to the size first.所以呢，主要你是要先剪出大概你的这个纸的这个提盒的尺寸。So have to cut out first, okay? I already cut out the size. This one is around 5.1 cm. 这个呢，我剪出的呢是大概是 5.1 的尺寸， 5.1 cm 的尺寸。And also, I already mark here is facing up. 所以我这里也是已经做了记号，这个是朝上。So have to glue like this. So this rice paper is very easy to glue actually. 而且其实棉纸非常容易粘。它你看你拉它也不会烂。You see, even though you pull like this, it won't spoil. Like the tissue is not easy to spoil easily. And also it won't expand. 然后主要呢它也不会，你拉的时候呢它也不会延伸，也不会发。OK? 我不懂那个话音要怎么说，就是说它不会给你拉的好像会变形啦 OK So usually I glue I using mixed media glue 我喜欢用这个多媒材的拼贴胶我觉得这个非常好用 To me it's very very nice to use Also depends on how you use For me I can use this tub 100 This one is only 150 ml But I can make at least 30 pieces of 14 cm tiffin虽然这个只有150ml, 但是呢我自己呢我本身呢可以做大概30个提盒就是看你如何使用啦。So apply a layer of the glue on top, no need to be very thick. I think some of you, because you can do only maybe 10 or 15 because you apply too thick. 有一些人呢可能你涂得太厚了所以你只可以做十多个。其实棉纸和餐巾纸呢都是非常薄的你不需要很多都非常容易粘上 Because the rice paper and the tissue actually is very thin So actually you no need to apply a lot of medium then it's easy to glue Okay, it's very easy to glue Just like that Apply a layer Make sure the edges here and the bottom here also you have the glue 你要确保这里和这里都有涂上那个胶然后呢这个纸呢有一部分的地方呢到这里呢我是不会铺那个胶水的 because the paper we need connection because one piece of this paper cannot wrap the whole thing so we need two pieces later I will teach you how 因为这张纸呢它一张呢下来它是没有办法包完整个 所以我们需要等一下要 有另外一张跟它结合在一起。所以呢，因为我们没有整个包完，所以呢我这边会留， 我就不涂胶水了。 And because we cannot cover the whole thing, so I will leave a little space that I don't apply the glue, because the glue later will be very sticky, it's very hard for me to do. So here no glue, 这边呢就不需要，就不需要放胶水了。大概我知道是这个位置， because I roughly know around this, this measurement around here, no need to put the glue, because I know this how long is it. Then after that, this glue is very good that you have to blow dry. Have to blow dry first. If you don't blow dry, it's actually not sticky. Just blow dry. 我先把它吹干。如果你没有吹干，其实它基本上是不会粘的。Okay, so blow dry first. 先吹干。Okay, just blow. Like this. 就是这样子吹就可以了，你不用担心吹很久哦，因为吹很久它都是会粘的。So you no need to worry how long you blow. Even though you blow very long, it's still very sticky. Okay, so the position here, no glue. So I have to start from here. 这里是没有胶水的，我从这里开始。So we also have to check where is the position. This one is facing up. You see on my arrow already marked. 我这里已经做了一个记号，这里是朝上的。So 我要从这里开始拼贴。你要看你自己的方向了。So you have to look at a direction which is convenient for you.你自己觉得舒服的方向，我就喜欢从这里开始。有一些人可能从这里开始。Some you might start from here, but I like to start from here. 只是我喜欢从这里开始，就对准就好了。So usually I will look at the top. 一般上呢，我都会看上。如果上面已经是平的，我就不用担心下面。If the top already tally and parallel, so I no need to worry about the bottom. So usually I will look at the top. You see, this glue is very good. So if you make mistake, you still can lift up.这个胶呢很好呢，就是你做错了，我随时我可以这样子把它拉上来，不用担心。You see, I can always lift up if I make mistake. I found that if the line is not tally or is not straight, okay, 如果我发觉它的线不直呢，我都可以随时把它拉起来，没有关系，就是很方便。It's very easy, you see, just follow the top line. 我只是跟着上面的这条线就好了， okay?Just like that. See, very simple. Sometimes I pull a bit also. 有时候呢，我也会拉一下，我想让它更直嘛，或者是我让它要跟它平行，所以有时候我都会稍微拉一下，它也 OK, 没有问题的。但是有时候因为这些 ，sometimes you see because this is rice paper, a lot of fiber, so the fiber will make it a light. You can feel the light.Like wingles, actually it's not wingle. 就是因为这个是棉子，它有很多纤维，有一些纤维会比较粗，所以你摸起来你感觉到好像是有皱纹。其实 like this one is because the fiber, so just glue back will do. 所以好像这样子的情形呢，这个是因为它的纤维，你去把它粘下去就可以了，不用担心。OK, just like that. OK, done. Then I press it out.完成了过后呢，我就把它这样子压下去，压 ，OK, just like that. Then also you can use the scraper. 然后呢，这样子的过后呢，我会用刮板，刮板很重要。这件作品呢，我很喜欢用刮板，因为刮板呢，它会让你的作品呢更加服帖。I like to use scraper because scraper will make your project much nicer and much very very smooth.That's why a lot of friends and customer followers and students ask me, "Hey teacher, why your tiffin is very smooth, no wingle, no creases at all?" Because I use scraper. 因为呢，其实很多很多人都有简讯问，哎，老师，你的提盒真的很滑，很平滑，你是怎样做到的？其实就是用这个刮板啦。So is that I use this scraper.I use this scraper. You have to make sure you really scrape it, okay? 那你要确保你就每一寸的地方你都是要这样子刮。So very important step is here, okay? Just like that, every single part. Then here, not enough glue. Never mind. Just now, now you can put back the glue. 好像这里呢，我刚才没有放到拼贴胶，对不对？现在把它放回来就可以了。所以呢，我们现在把拼贴胶放回来，一样的做法。So it's the same. Just put back the glue. Okay, here. Just enough. No need to be very thick. 足够就可以了，不需要很厚。Like that. Then blow dry. 还是一样，把它先吹一下。吹了过后是黏黏的。You see, after blow dry is sticky. Just press it out. Just like that. You see, done already. You see, very, very smooth. Now I can also glue back this fiber, okay? 我也把这个纤维先粘回去。And also, you no need to worry about that the glue will touch here or you have glue on top. You can clean later. 然后你也不用担心你有那种 那些你的那个胶会涂上来，没有关系，这个等一下我们可以清掉。You can clean with the wet tissue. 其实你可以用那个湿纸巾把它擦掉就可以了。Like that, done. Okay, now we will see how to do the connection here. 这样子就完成了。现在呢，我们来看一下要如何做这个连接的地方。Okay, we have to take out this paper and check the position. 我们要把这张纸剩下的纸呢拿出来，然后我们看一下它连接的地方。Okay, here is the remaining paper. So now I have to check, okay? 这个是剩下的纸咯。Okay, 我已经剪了这里，然后这个是剩下的，我们现在来检查一下。So you see here is the same, right? So I will cut from here 5.1 cm. 所以这边是一样的，看到吗？这里连接线。Can you see? The connection line here is exactly here.Okay, it's exactly here. So in this case, you will see at least one joining line here. 所以在这里呢，你就会看到最起码有一个连接线。Okay, 所以呢，这里呢，基本上如果你粘得很好的话呢，你是看不出的。Is here basically if you can glue very well, you won't really see the line. Okay, this paper is very good that you don't really see another line. Okay, like here, what I did is If you do well, actually you don't really see the line. 如果你好像这个一样，如果你做得很好呢，基本上你不会太明显的看到连接线。If you do it well, basically you don't see the line very obviously, okay? So actually it's here, there's a line, okay? 这里会有一条，另外一条应该是在这里。Another one it will be here. So but not really clear, okay? Not really very obvious.If you do well. Okay, like this one I don't do very well because my cutting's problem. So you can see quite obvious. 这个呢我做的不是很好，因为我剪的时候呢出了一些状况，所以这个会比较明显。但是我相信你会做得更好。But I believe that you can do much better than me. So another line might be here. 还有另外一条应该是这里啦。我另外一条就看不得很清楚。Another one is not so clear. So at least you see one joining. If you do it very well and you observe and you pay attention. 如果你真的很专心很专注的话，就没有什么看得出那个连接线啦。Okay, same as this one. Okay.So now let us try this one here. So I have to cut out here. Here is exactly this part. 这个呢就是这里啦。我先把它剪出来 5.1 cm. My defense size here is 5.1. So I will measure 5.1 and I cut out. Okay, 我这里大概是 5.1 cm 的公分 5.1 公分。所以我先把它剪出来。Okay, I already cut out. I no need to cut the whole line, yeah?Okay, 我不需要剪整个，因为我只需要一点点就足够了。Because I need only here. So you no need to cut the whole piece. So, 1.14 cm defin two tier is enough, okay? Is one piece of this A3 size is enough for you to make a 14 cm two tier defin. 所以一张呢 A3 尺寸的这个棉纸是足够给你做一个这个14 cm 14公分两层的提盒的。你看这里呢，你还会有一条 5.2 cm 的， Here you will cut another 5.1 cm. Here remaining, you can do the cover. You see exactly. So you know you have to measure it nicely. OK, 所以呢你自己如何量呢是非常重要的，所以你要很小心，你剪裁是非常重要的。 The way you cut the measurement is you should be very careful. That actually is enough for you to make one 14 cm tiffin to dear. 所以一张呢是足够给你做14公分两层的提盒。 OK, 现在我们来看一下。 So this one I already cut out. So the position is exactly here. 所以你看这里是这样子，对不对？所以我们先把它贴上。 So now I have to put the glue again. 一样，先把这个多媒材的拼贴胶先涂上来。 So here exactly, and don't forget the edges, 不要忘记这里上面。然后呢，刚刚好是到这里的，不需要很厚， no need to be very thick. Okay, but enough, okay, must be enough.不需要很厚，但是是足够的哦。OK, 不要又放得太少，如果太少呢，等一下它也粘不上。Not too little, if too little, maybe you cannot glue well also. So I always mention that enough, OK? 所以我每次都会强调说是足够的，但是呢不需要很厚，但是是足够的。一样，我们要先把它吹干。So the same step, we have to blow dry.Okay, after blow dry, now we have to glue down. 所以呢，现在对吹干了，我们要对准准哦。Here is very careful. You have to do very carefully. Have to look carefully exactly the position. Then you see like that. Can you see clearly? 看得清楚吧？你看我这样子粘上去，基本上你就看不到那个线了。You see, if I glue like that, basically you cannot see the line anymore, right?So you must be, this one is a very detailed, that's why you have to really be careful and pay attention. 这个是非常重要。所以呢你粘的时候呢你要真的是非常小心，然后你真的是要很专心很专注。OK? Here might run a bit because my cutting maybe here.这里呢有时候你要做几次， Sometimes you need to do few times to get the correct position. Okay, find the correct position. 有时候呢你真的是要做好几次，慢慢去将就一下那个位置。 So, to adjust. Okay, like that I found is okay already. Can already see my line, yeah? 所以你没有你不是很看得清楚我那条线在哪里了，对不对？ Okay, like thatThis one we can use a scraper later. Then here extra also fold down. 这边多余的呢要把它先折下来，要折得刚刚好那条线。So have to fold exactly the extra, exactly the line. 所以这里是刚刚好的连接线，刚刚好的哦。一点都不能够多， cannot be a little more even though 0.1111 cm. Okay, then fold and press.折了过后呢压一下，你就要用刀片把它剪掉，用刀片 then use the cutter to cut out. Okay, then basically it's like that lah. Then done. Then now I will teach you how to use the varnish. 现在呢我就来教你如何用那个保护剂。 Okay, like that. Nicely done. 这样子就完成了，有没有？Okay, so it's very easy. Then also using the scraper is very important. 然后还是要用这个刮板刮一下啦。Okay, all the part before you varnish, you have to scraper first. This is a very detailed tutorial. You can also share to your friend who make tiffin. So it's very useful if you cannot do your tiffin nicely without wrinkles, using the rice paper, then you can watch this video and share to your friend who is making the tiffin using the rice paper. And the same technique also you can use apply to using the tissue on the tissue. 同样的技法呢，其实你也可以用在餐巾纸上面。我有另外一个视频是教餐巾纸的。I have another video actually is using the rice paper, the tissue. 所以呢，你可以分享给你的朋友咯。你的朋友有人是做这个提盒，但是他们做的不好，有很多皱褶的，你可以分享给他。So now I will teach you how to do using Suni as matte varnish and glossy varnish. Matte and glossy varnish to me is a very...very good to good protection. Okay, I basically now I like now because my glossy varnish is launched lately. 现在呢，我很喜欢这样子用，因为我们的这个亮光保护剂是最近才推出的，所以呢，我觉得它最好的效果呢，就是先涂这个至少两层到三层，然后再涂这个好几层，这样子它就会达到很好的保护效果，而且它非常亮。So to me now, yeah, because we just launched this lately, I found that the best result is I apply this few layers, 2 to 3 layers of the matte varnish, then I apply another few layers of glossy varnish. It will reach a very, very good protection. Same time, will be very shining. Now I share with you how to use it. 所以我就先来分享如何使用这个。Put here. I just make this one using the water slide that day. 这个是我那天才做的，用我们的那个 easy transfer 的水转印子，就把它打来这里。Okay. So, as you know, I like to use a very good brush for my varnish and the painting. 所以你也知道，一般上你都知道，我很喜欢用这个很好的软毛笔来做那个，做什么？就是上色啊，然后还有涂这个亮光保护剂 ，okay? But you can use any brush you have. I like to use angular because it's easy to go to the edges. 我喜欢用斜笔，因为斜笔很容易去到这些位置 ，okay? Just apply like that one layer first without water, no water, don't add water. 不要加水，一定要记得不要加水。这个你有看到我是拿的很多的 ，You can see I use like this generous amount, okay? 所以我拿的时候是多的，你看是这样子多的，不要加水，你看它都是很滑的哦。If you glue very well, it won't pop up, same as the tissue. Because a lot of people they ask me, "Hey, teacher, when I varnish."My tissue or rice paper tends to pop up. Why? Because you don't glue well. Maybe your glue is not sticky enough. That's why it pop up. It will have some wrinkles or whatever bubble. Okay? 有些人会问我说，诶，老师，当我涂这个亮光保护剂的时候，我的那个餐巾纸或者是我的棉纸，它都会起皱，为什么呢？主要原因是因为你的那个拼贴胶不够粘。OK, 你粘的不好，它才会有这样子的问题。So basically, if you don't glue well, they have this problem. You see, if I glue well, my glue is very good, it's very sticky, very nicely. You see, I have no pop up at all. 你看，你可以看到，它是没有起皱纹的。You can see no wrinkles or no creases or what you call that, like the bubble at all. You can see very, very nicely, very, very smooth.Okay, one layer, now I have the blow dry. 一层了过后呢，我先把它吹干 blow dry. Now I apply the second layer, okay? 现在我涂第二层。So it's up to you whether you want to use the scraper or not after the first or the second layer of the, after first layer of the varnish. It's up, totally up to you. If you found that it's very smooth already, then you don't use, it's fine.你看基本上呢，你如果你要涂上那个，你要用刮板也可以，你不用也可以。如果你觉得它已经很平滑了，你涂了一层，你不要用刮板再刮都可以，没有问题。So 都是取决于你 ，it's up to you. But if you want to use the scraper again, you have to make sure you have to blow very very dry before you use the scraper. 如果你还是想用刮板再刮的话呢，你一定要确保你吹得非常干。这里也是要上，这里也是 ，here and here.Must also have the varnish, and don't worry about the varnish. Well, varnish here, you can clean later. 不用担心你的那个亮光保护剂来到这里，不用担心。等下我们一样的可以把它清掉。Okay, blow dry, 吹干。Okay, now after 3 layers already, you can see very shining already.Okay, if you don't want to use a glossy varnish, you can use this one 5 or more layers, okay? 如果你不想用那个亮光 的保护剂呢，你也可以只是用平光的5到更多的层，这样子就会达到非常好的保护效果了。然后也有很多人问我说，可以洗吗？绝对是可以洗的。 A lot of people also ask me whether can wash or not. Definitely can wash, and I already experiment. I soak into the water more than 24 hours and the paper still look very nice, okay?然后呢，我也做过试验了，我已经把它泡在水里超过24小时，而且这个纸还是非常好，只是有起一点皱纹。Just that, after 24 hours, the paper is already a bit crumbled, but it's very nice also. So no worries, it definitely can be washed. Now I change now to this glossy varnish. Just shake. Glossy varnish is watery. A lot of people very scared that it's watery. It's like that, but it's very shining. 很多人很担心说，哎，这个亮光呢，它是很水，其实它蛮好用，你不用加水啦，直接这样子用就可以了。 And no need to add water, you just use directly like this. It's very convenient. To me, it's very nice to use. You see? Just like that. 对我来说呢，这个是非常容易使用，你看就很光了。 You see? Just one layer, you will see very shining already. Okay, all the parts here. 一层，你涂了好几层的平光过后呢，你就涂亮光，它就一看。它的效果真的是很我蛮喜欢它的效果啦。 I really like the effect after the glossy, you see? Shining. Very, very nice, you see? Can see? And also, I make a mistake at that. I have to tell you, sometimes teacher also make mistake, okay? 不好意思，我有一个地方做的不好，所以老师有时候也是会出错，我们都是在错误中学习嘛， so we always learn from the mistake.So what is the problem is here. Can you see? Here. Can you see? So, can you see this one? 你可以看到这里吗? The aroma, I forgot to erase it. 我忘了把它擦掉，我要粘之前。所以你们要粘之前，你们要注意咯，这个一定要把它擦掉。So you have to erase it, the arrow, the mark. Just now I mark it, have to facing up. 这个是我做了一个记号，这个是要向上的。所以呢，你要轻轻的，或者是你可以轻轻的写。Or you can write it very lightly. This one how I touch up, I will touch up with the color later. 这个呢，我等一下就会用颜色补上，就在 不在这里分享了。所以呢，这样子呢，我们就大概涂它3-4层就 OK 了。当然你越涂越多层越好。Of course, if you can varnish many layers, the more the best, okay? So I will show you after few layers, I blow dry first. 我等一下会给你看看几层过后呢，它的效果，先把它吹干。Okay, you see, this one is after 3 layers of the glossy varnish, you see, very, very shining, yeah? 你看这个就是我涂了3层那个亮光保护剂，3层的那个平光，然后3层的亮光， 3 layers of the matte and 3 layers of the glossy. Why I need to apply the matte varnish first? 为什么我要先涂平光呢？因为平光呢，它没有那么水嘛，它不容易渗透到纸里面去，然后它你的纸就不会，就会比较快的就会发光。OK, 因为它不容易吸收进去。Why I like to use the matte varnish first? Because the matte is very thick and also it not easy to absorb into the paper. Then very fast, it will be very shining. That's why I like this one to use as the base varnish first. 所以我喜欢这个先拿来做成打底的那个平光的，然后我才用亮光，然后就比较深 and also more safe. Use both together, you can save a lot. OK, you see, very shining. Very nice, yeah?你看是不是很光，而且 you see very smooth, you can see very smooth, 你也可以看到它很平的，没有皱褶的。皱褶的这些呢，其实 is not the, 不是皱褶， as you can see, this kind is not the wrinkles or not the creases or whatever, this one is the fiber. 这个呢其实就是那个纤维，这种这样子的你看得到的，这个你以为是皱褶，其实它是纤维， is a fiber, okay?Hope you like my sharing today. 希望你喜欢我今天的分享咯。你可以分享给朋友，你也可以给我点一个赞。You can share to your friend or you can give me a like. Thank you. See you next time. 我们下次见哦。Bye bye. See you next time. Bye.